Konnichiwa. Today's daily devotional is for January the 24th, 2020. And it's called Don't Let Them Fly the Coop Before You Get the Scoop. Okay, I'm going to start with Ephesians 4:25. Therefore, having put away falsehood, let each one of you speak the truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another. Okay, so I read a story that happened in Florida on December the 29th, 2019, and it's about a man calling the police on his neighbor because he heard a woman's voice screaming, "Help, let me out." Okay, well, when the police arrived, the man who was outside, you know, he was putting the brakes on his wife's car. You know, he was in the carport, and he was stunned, and he was oblivious as of what was going on. Okay, so that brings me to Romans 15:2. Let each of us please his neighbor for his good, to build him up. All right, so the cops told him that his neighbor had sung like a bird. Okay, his next door neighbor. And, you know, he ratted him out. Okay, and the man sat there for a second like, you know, Sylvester, who he got caught with Tweety Bird in his mouth. You know, he's like the cat with the canary stuck in his mouth. And he laughed and he told him, he said that that was his 40-year-old parrot named Rambo, you know, that was sitting there on the porch, perched up, singing and rambling on. He said that, he had Rambo since he was a little boy, okay? And you know how little kids are. And Rambo, at the time, he kept him in a cage. So he taught Rambo to scream, "Let me out, help," you know? So that's who was making that noise. It was not a woman, okay? So it was just so funny. So he was just used to him singing those words, you know, so he just would tune him out. And after 40 years, you hear it and you don't think anything of it. So the officers all fell out with laughter after. And a little birdie flew over and told the nosy neighbor, and told him too, because he hollered laughing as well. All right, so of course I'm going to show you guys a picture, because Rambo is too stinking cute. I did not make this up, guys. I am not crazy. Do you see that? He is something else, all right? Okay? All right. Okay, so that brings me to Luke 15:20 through 24. So he got up and went to his father, but while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion for him. He ran to his son, threw his arms around him and kissed him. The son said to him, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son." But the father said to his servants, "Quick, bring the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet." All right, there are some men around here that take on female roles, okay, as single fathers, for whatever reasons. There's several reasons, okay? And I had a friend that raised his son and his daughter almost from birth, because the wife, his ex-wife, was a deadbeat mom, okay? That you guys didn't know there was some of them out there. Well, I know him personally. Okay, so the son, he was kind of mentally slow, and he would scream all the time too. Like when my friend would be changing his clothes and trying to give him a shower, he always screamed and cut up, and I would be cracking up laughing, you know? But he was a drama king, you know? And nobody, and my friend was used to him too doing that, okay? So when he moved to this new neighborhood, and which he lived over the landlord, okay? The landlord wasn't familiar with this. So one day the landlord's, it was husband and wife team, the husband, he heard the, you know, little boy screaming like a female, making, "Help me," and carrying on and all of that. So he was worried. So he told his wife to go check it out. So the wife went up there and she investigated, okay? And so like I said, my friend, he was used to it, so he was oblivious too. Like, what's going on? He said, oh, that you must hear my son, and he told him what was going on. All right, and so when they told them, they, you know, he was like really shocked. All right, so that brings me to James 2:8. If you really fulfill the royal law according to the scripture, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. You are doing well. Okay, so like I said, he was oblivious as to what was going on, all right? So when they told him, they were just laughing, and, you know, they embraced my son's friend because he's really cute. He's like a big baby Huey, like a big cartoon. Even to this day, he still looks the same, all right? And this was over 20 years ago. So that goes to show you that God is still the same today as he was yesterday, and he's still working things out in our life. He comes to our rescue, to works with us, so we can work peace and live peaceably amongst our neighbors. Okay, all right. So my power thought for you guys is spread the gospel, not gossip that you heard like a bird. All right, and I have the cutest picture of about single dads. Just realized they were all single dads. Did you guys know that? Different cartoon characters. Look at Disney. Goofy and that bulldog and the Little Mermaid and her dad and some little princes in the corner. I don't recognize that, but they were single dads too. So you dads are doing a great job. Love you guys. Have a great day. Mwah.